kind of show you, because I don't know what to call it.
Okay.
But like, okay, I'm going to take this, I'm going to get the code, and I'm going to put it in another box. I'm watching people walk outside. Crazy. I wouldn't be out there in that freezing cold weather.
They probably never seen snow in their life. They're excited.
My husband said, he said, well, they probably never lived in it. And right? I said, maybe. Okay, so now, David, when I click here to download my seller's guide, are you going to take me to this page to fix it? Because I don't know how to fix it.
Awesome. Awesome. Let's do that.
So that'll be something we will be doing later.
No, we can do that right now. Let's do that right now.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, so let's X out of here. And let's go into the Kartra. Let's go into the edit. So click the three dots and just click on edit.
Okay. Close this. Okay. To that same page, right?
Yes.
Okay. You'll be proud of me. I figured out how to download a video on Kartra.
Awesome.
And I inserted it in that in the thank you page.
Oh, you did that part already?
I did it already.
Awesome. Awesome. Great job.
You
gotta take a look at it.
Have to make sure it's right, because I'm not sure.
Yeah, for sure. So in this case, with this simple opt-in form, that's what it is. It's the opt-in form. So all we're gonna do is simply hover over the button and then let's go into edit. So let's hit the edit on the button. Yeah, that pencil. And then over here, it's the link. So click on link right at the top, link. So here in this case, it's a pop-up form. So when they click a button, I can send them wherever. Like, for example, link to another Kartra page. That would take them to a Kartra page or link to another page, excuse me. I could take them to a Kartra page or I could take them to a completely different page with link to another page, scroll to a particular section of a page, download a file. So there's many different things. Yours is the opt-in form. So all we're going to do is we're going to hover over to the right. So let's scroll to the right, that red square. That's where the image is at for the background. So just hit edit. So let's change. Let's hit edit right there, the pencil.
Oh, wait. Yes, I'm sorry.
And then this background image is right here. So click on image and then you can change up that image.
One to the same picture I have on the other one.
Yeah, that'd be good. Or something different. I mean, you can always
give me the
same one, select it, and then just hit confirm and then click apply. Yeah, and then also what you can do is you can change the opacity. So that 30%, change that to, just play around with that. Change it to 70%, see what it looks like. Change it to...
Oh, it was there already? I'm sorry. Opacity, where is the opacity?
No, go image. So that opacity, image opacity, 30%.
Okay.
So just play around with it. Yeah, play around with it. Go to 70, see what it looks like, 70. Hit apply. You got to always click apply.
To be able to see it.
Yeah, see, so that brings it out more. You know, then you could probably go to 90. It'll probably bring it out even more, but that looks good too.
Yeah, I think that looks
good. Yeah, so that looks good. So you can always just hover over the text and you can change the text. So there's the T.
I have to remember how to do that though. So
the T, yeah. You can change the T. You can. If you have a headline already in mind.
I don't.
Okay. So whatever you wrote on the landing page, just write it right there.
And I can't remember what I wrote on the
landing page. So X out of that configuration to the left, just click the X, get rid of that. Yeah. So you can see what you're looking at. So you can always just hover over
what?
Or do you want to change this text or do it later?
Yeah. I want to change the text, but I know what I could do. Let me just
open up the page.
Yeah, I have things to consider when selling your house. So I can say, things to consider before selling your home.
Yeah.
Something like
perfect.
That sounds
perfect. Maybe use the white. Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Things to consider before selling your home. Awesome.
Okay, that looks
good. And now, hold on real quick. So now hover over the form right there. Hit that edit, the pencil right there, the edit pencil. And now change the text in the button. So go to the button, click on button. Yeah. Click on button, okay. The top. No, click on.
Okay.
There's the text for the button. You can even change the color.
Oh, gotcha.
See, and this is just what I call your back end. This is what I call your machine. Once you build this machine, it's a one-time thing. It's obviously the most time-consuming part. But once you freaking build it, it's a machine. Now all you do is just feed the machine, and this could be a lead generating machine for you, you know, that you set up one time and then you just leverage, you know, with running ads.
Right. Cause you can use the same when I do other sellers guide ads, use the exact same stuff, right?
Oh, I
don't have to do it again. Good.
Yeah. So you can just clone it. So you can clone your landing page, change out the image. Now use it for your buyer guide. Or clone it, you know, change out the image and use it for a listing, you know, right. And just do the minor changes and yeah. So it becomes very easy once you really get the hang of it. You could just do something once and just duplicate it over and over and over and just use the same type of, you know, template.
Yeah. But so, you will help me one more, right? So I'll remember. So I'll know.
Oh,
now.
No, we're going to be on this for many more. And I'm also starting group calls as well. That starts this Wednesday, which you'll get an email about. So every Monday and Wednesday, I'm going to be going on Zoom with a group of Kartra users and just teaching. I'll be doing it myself, hosting it. And we'll just be, it's just going to be a Q&A. So Kartra has their Q&A every Tuesday and Thursday. I'm going to have my live Zoom Q&A every Monday and Wednesday. And that's going to be at 3 p.m. Central.
Perfect.
So every Monday and Wednesday, any random Kartra question, yes, jump on. You'll get an email, but just jump on and learn this stuff with me.
Okay.
Yes. So there's that.
And so somebody, it's okay that it has my name and email in there?
No, that's just Kartra's artificial intelligence reading your computer. The fact that you're on your computer and that's your information, they're just pre-populating. That's how smart this system is. So So if, for example, if somebody else, actually, when you're in here, hold up, get out of there real quick, out of the actions, move out of there. When you're in a form, you have to, click out of that actions, get rid of that preview, save progress, get rid of that. So click below.
Got it.
Whenever you're in a form and you're editing a form, always click done right there. To the right. Always click done first, or else that for some reason that doesn't save. I don't know why. And then hit actions and then save progress. So just save progress every few minutes if you can.
Yeah.
So what I was saying, what was I saying? I was saying
how it is that it auto-populates.
Oh yeah. So if anyone has ever been on a page of yours before and then they come to your page on their computer, their information will already be there. It's kind of just like Kartra is just helping them and pre-populating it for them, which helps your conversion. Yeah, which helps your conversion, which is crazy. So it's amazing.
I can do this and see if I get anything.
Yeah. So click here to download my seller's guide now. Okay, cool. So let's publish live. Let's publish live. And then all you have to do now is go and open up. Yeah, let's X out of this, close. And then let's scroll down real quick. Scroll down. Let me look at the footer. Everything okay on the footer? Everything. So there's your bookmark. I mean, not your bookmark, but your copyrights. And then all the icons are saved.
I think I've got them right. Yeah. And I went ahead and did what you showed me last time. Okay. I made this footer a favorite. Uh-huh. So now it's there on my footers whenever I want to.
Awesome. So you saved it. All you did is hit the red square, hit the heart. Go into your saved real quick. So hit component or hit sections to the left. What do you have saved? Let's just, because I want to make this.
The only one I have saved is the footer.
Hit favorite at the top. Favorites.
Oh, Is that where I got it from?
Okay, so yeah, get rid of the EXP one. Get rid of the EXP one. Even get rid of that top one, that darker right. one. Yeah, get rid of that one. That way you just, over here, you just start collecting all of your, you know, assets that you want to use over and over and over. That footer is perfect for all your pages from this point on. Now, yeah. Here's the deal. I'm glad we're here. Get out of there. Hit the X, block templates. Go back down to the bottom. Here's the deal. I'm glad I'm catching this. On the landing, get rid of that. Hit that X right there. X that out. Now you saved it and that's fine. But no, down. The hover over the icons right where you're at.
Oh, that here? X.
No. The icons. X that out. On a landing page, you don't need any of that. So on a landing page, you don't want your social media icons.
No.
It's only on the thank you page. So when you get to the thank you page, then you can connect with me on social media.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Because the last thing you wanted to be doing is running Facebook ads, getting people to click and come here. And then instead of hitting the yellow button, they click and they follow you on LinkedIn.
Okay.
I don't want to pay for you to follow me on LinkedIn. You know what I mean? I'm paying for you to click the yellow button.
Right.
So the less distraction, the better. What you want to do also, and this is just for the landing page. This is just for landing pages that you're driving traffic to, that you're running Facebook ads on, just for the landing page. Let me send you something really quick that I want you to add. I'm going to send it to you in the actual chat, in the chat box here on Zoom. So go to the chat and let's just...
Where is the chat? I don't see it. Do you? Oh, wait, here it is. This is it. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. Maybe that isn't the chat.
You know what? I want you to put the whole thing. So go into the chat, grab that, copy that whole thing. So go ahead and open up the chat.
Where is the chat? Is this it?
No, it's right there on the bottom. Right by your share screen. It's right there, the orange. Yeah.
Oh, it's underneath. Yeah, it's underneath on mine.
So can you move that? See if you can drag and or hide. Just click hide. Yeah, hide.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, so perfect.
Why I couldn't see it.
So copy this entire, all that verbiage, copy all of that. And then let's go to Kartra real quick. And what I'm going to have you do is simply grab. So scroll to the very bottom of the page. And then just to the very left, go to maybe sections. Is it sections and components? Those are the only two things we work out of, but I always get them confused. So hit sections real quick. See if it's in there. We're looking for the text. So just... I think it's in components. It's in components.
Yeah, probably is.
Yeah, so look for text and just click on text. I think it's up. Yeah, it's up. So grab a text folder or block, the top one. Yeah, that's actually the only one. And all you're going to do is click and drag it below your copyrights.
Should I delete what's in here then?
No. Yeah, we're going to delete that. That's just an example. So click and drag it below. Drag it below your copyright.
All right, but don't you want me to put the right text in it?
Yeah, you are, Christine. Just click it, drag it below.
Oh, really? All right.
Yeah.
Click this?
Yeah, click it, drag it. Don't let it go. Go to the bottom, drag it below. Put it below your copyrights. So just keep going. Yeah. Yeah, you might have to find that fine line of...
Below the copyright.
Right there. There we go. Perfect. Yeah. Right below the copyrights. Bam. Oh.
Did you go? Hold on.
Oh, it's somewhere on the page. Look, scroll back up. I think it might be the top. Okay, I thought you, that's why you can't let it go, because then, oh, what happened? Right there, drop it. Perfect. Okay, so now X out of the block templates, or yeah, just so you can give yourself some space, or you can see.
Oh, and now I'm gonna change it.
Yeah, now hit the T and then just paste in that, hit the T, no, the T.
Oh.
Okay, so just delete all that and then just paste in what you got. Okay, so this right here is important for a landing page. And so just change out my name, change out my company name, and just put your name. And you can even make the font even a little smaller if you want, but that's fine right there. But
Put my name or
just replace your information, my name, your company name, just replace it. So this is just what Facebook looks for. It's like a disclaimer. So Facebook would notice this and appreciate it. I mean, they want stuff like this to be compliant. So what I would do is I would just maybe, let's finish this and then let's just drop it even lower. So.
Okay. And then make it smaller, you think?
No, I mean, well, actually maybe go a little smaller. See if you can go 0.5. It's at 0.6, but see if you can go to a point. I don't know if you have to highlight it.
Oh, I have to get the text again, don't I?
Just double click, copy it.
That's not
over it. Just hover over it and then hit the pencil. Now hit the pencil. So now what we're going to do is just bring the margin. So that margin, move it all the way to the right, the little dot.
Oh, this one? This thing?
Yeah, move it to the very right and then click apply.
All the way to the right?
All the way. Okay, so that just dropped it. Okay, perfect. So now save progress. Actually, the icons, get rid of those icons. The reason why they showed back up again is because you didn't publish live. So save progress, publish live, and then return to dashboard. And this page is good to go. Perfect. Publish live. Okay, so now you could just get out of here. So now we'll just close and then return a dashboard, actions, and then return a dashboard. And that's pretty much different editing of a page, but that's what was needed at the bottom. So go to your actual page, Free Seller Guide, the tab.
Okay, is this the only page where we really have to put that?
That's the only page. That's the only page.
Where are we going?
Every landing page, I should say. Every landing page, yeah, put that. So click on that one. Actually, well, never mind. So just get out of here. Let's just get out of here. So all the editing, that's kind of just basics of how to edit a simple page.